Blogger With A Cuppa, with a bottle, obviously. Oh my god. Well, first thing I'm going to talk about on my Blogger With A Cuppa is that stupid EU referendum thing on ITV that's just finished. It was like watching an upper-class version of Jeremy Kyle, wasn't it? Instead, when they're finished on this TV programme, they're going to go back to the rich bitch houses and rich bastard residences, aren't they? Oh, it was awful. All you can hear was me, 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 and me, 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 and me, 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 me. Shut up. Another couple of weeks we've got of this. Ugh. Grief. None of them really care. Anyway, so on the front of today's Metro, in another story, it's talking about hand dryers. And Dyson is advertising their new hand dryers. And on the back, it shows you how they work. They've put some blue light thing in it so to make it cleaner. Because, you see, we all like Dyson hand dryers. Or do we? Because I think, pardon me, it's fizzy lemonade. Bit of lemonade. I hate rubbish hand dryers. I think we all do. This is nothing new, is it? You know the ones where you put your hand in and it goes, and then cuts out, and then you think, oh, thanks, and you end up wiping them all over yourself and creating more dirt and germs. Well, I think the best hand dryers are the Excelsior ones, the silver ones, because they blow really fast. Because I think the Dyson ones, where you put your hands in like that, they've always got that cradle of dirt in the middle, haven't they? You know, they're not cleaned very well, and the water just rolls off the edge. Yes, but so I think that's Dyson's addressing the problem by putting in this blue light thing as well. So they're just creating another normal hand dryer, what dries your hands properly. So I think that's good. Because there's far too many naff hand dryers out there, aren't they? Just making unnecessary noise and dirt and everything like that. There's not a lot to talk about in the news today because it's been dominated by this EU referendum boosh, which is just more lies, lies. The other major story is obviously the owner of BHS threatened somebody. Owner's threat to kill BHS boss. Gosh, it's all coming out in the wash now, isn't it? And it's really sad because it's turned into this massive story. And the fundamental thing is 11,000 people have lost the job because of greed. And from past owners of BHS, it's absolutely disgusting. Other things in the news, flicking through the Evening Standard, I didn't see much. I do have other things to comment on though. I'm finally getting rid of my Microsoft phone. Look, this thing is absolutely crap. I hate it. I want to say it's the worst phone I've ever had, but in the past I did have a worse phone. I think this is my joint worst phone I've ever had, ever. I hate it so much. It was unresponsive and crap. I threw it so many times and it's continued to work on that front. So that's Nokia's manufacturing. The problem with it is Microsoft. It was slow. Well, it's wrong to call it slow. No, it's not wrong to call it slow, actually. You could throw this thing and a snail would beat it till it, you know what I'm saying. I've ruined the joke now by stuttering, haven't I? Now I'm going to get that joke out. Pretend you just didn't sit last couple of seconds. You could throw this phone and before it's hit the ground, a snail could have beaten it. There you are. There's the joke. So instead, I've bought myself a LG phone, LG, and it's an Android phone. So, you know, it's going to work. So I'm really happy with myself for that. I bought this phone bland though because I knew nought about it, but I just wanted a new phone. Downside is it didn't have a camera on the front. But what I will say about this one, because of the manufacturing of it, the camera on the front bit of this one was actually quite good. And that was it. You know, if I wanted to buy a camera, I'd have bought a camera. But anyway, I can use it independently, so that's good, I suppose. So I can still film on that. But I can actually text and call and everything, my new LG one. I'm already beginning to love it. So that's that for everything. That's what I wanted to talk about in the Blogger With A Cuppa. Not much to talk about. It's just, oh my god. They're still talking about the EU referendum. And now they've got a family from Leicester and a family from Wickford in Essex. So giving their views and stuff like that. And Paisley. I don't care. Just, oh god. I'm looking forward to the 24th of June, to be honest with you. So it's all done and over with. Anything else to comment on in the news? I don't think there is. This Blogger With A Cuppa is quite long because I've not really looked at the news, to be honest with you. I've been far too busy I've been at work sorting out this new phone. I got a load of... Oh my God, let me show you the new fan that I got. Look at this. It winds up. I got it from Target for a quid. So look. Looks a bit nerdified, but it's brilliant. I love it. Well, it's better than using one of these, isn't it? Because if you saw me walking down the street with one of these... Hey, Mr. Hopkinson! You made me a blush! That's weird. So anyway, thanks for watching this blogger with a cuppa, even though it was with a bottle again. And please crass, and I'll see yous when I see yous. Bye!